Hey again, everybody, and welcome. It's John with People's Republic, and today we've got a premiere draft of Crimson Vow. Before we jump into the action, this channel stands with the Black Lives Matter movement, so please do check out the links to funds and charities in the YouTube video descriptions, and consider giving part of your monthly magic budget or anything that you would donate to my channel to one of those worthwhile causes. All right, let's do it. I haven't had a whole lot more exposure to the format yet, beyond what we talked about last time I did a Crimson Vow draft. Wow, oh, there we go. I was about to comment on how long it took to fill the seats. Not that long, turns out. Okay, got a handful of good cards here. I think the rare is pretty good, but you really kind of want to be red-white before you take a card like that. Sorry, I'm gonna sneeze. There's also Ballista Watcher, which is just like a rock-solid card in the best color. Packsong Pup I like too, and Lantern Bearer is also good. I'm kind of leaning towards Ballista Watcher, so that we can get started into red. Let's go with that. So here, there's a Flame Blessed Bolt. Just lets us say red. I kind of like that. There's also a Screaming Swarm, a Fierce Retribution, some okay black stuff here, in Farmer, Gift of Fangs, and Grizzly Ritual. Honestly, though, I'm just going to take the Flame Blessed Bolt. Red card into red card. And, yeah, we've got, good black options, but also pretty good red options, too. There's Magma Pummeler, which I think is pretty good. And there's also Falconwrath Celebrants. In black, I really like Bloodcrazed Socialite. Blood Fountain's good. Desperate Farmer's good. But I don't see a reason to veer off red here. I think I just want the, Celebrants. Okay, so less great red here. I'm not interested in a Bloody Betrayal right now. Frenzied Devils goes in a very specific red deck, I think. Spiked Ripsaw is good. I think Cradle of Safety has a home. Brinecomber is the most powerful card in the pack. But it clearly does not go with anything that we've got right now. I think for me, it's going to be between the Ripsaw, the Brinecomber, and the Doom Dissenter. I think we should probably just take the Ripsaw, though. Okay, so we've got some green to follow it up. There's a Cloak Cadet. There's a Wolfkin Outcast. These are okay. Wolfkin Outcast, I guess, is pretty good. This is an S-Walt Shieldbearer in a Shield Basher in white and a Blood Fountain here, but I think I'll take the Outcast. Here, with a couple of green picks under our belt, I'd like to just go ahead and take a 2-drop creature. Best card in this pack is probably like Skywarp Scob. It's not even that great. I like Militia Rallyer fine. For us, I guess we can take this Weary Prisoner. I'm not excited about it. Get a Belligerent Guest here. There's also an Evolving Wilds, I guess, but I'll just take a guess. Alright, pack's starting to dry up here. I'd rather a Massive Might over a Lightning Wolf. Yeah, we get nothing here. I think the best card in the pack is probably the Pointed Discussion. I don't think we'll play Honored Heirloom, so I'm just going to take the Pointed Discussion in case we go back towards black. This is nice to see the Magma Pummeler come back. Because I think that that's a decently strong card. I've seen it do good work. Be a 2-for-1. It's, you know, very frequently like a 5-mana 3/3. I guess I'm gonna take this Bloody Betrayal. Yeah. It's not gonna end up in the deck. Okay. Take a Royal Recruiter, take a Cloak Cadet. I'm gonna take the Royal Recruiter. Alright. So not a great rare for us. But we do have a Reclusive Taxidermist. I think I'm in for that. There's no bangers in terms of the commons. Probably the best is like the Traveling Minister. Yeah, I'm just gonna take that Taxidermist. Alright, shame we didn't end up in black. But we do have an Abrade here, so I'm just gonna take that. Couple of decent removal spells. Nothing that's gonna deal with anything big, though. Got some okay creatures. Nothing great. Yeah. Just have to see how the rest of this pack goes. Okay, so two pretty good options between Ascendant Pack Leader and Alluring Suitor. Spell with mana value 4 or more. Gosh, this is tough. I wonder what's better. I think I'm actually going to take this Alluring Suitor. I don't know that that's right. But I'm just not that into it. 1 mana, 2/1. I think we just want the Wolf Strike here. I have not seen Oakshade Stalker be impressive. Okay, we got some stuff here. I think I want a 2-drop over the Sawblade Slinger. I've also had the Slinger just not be that great. If it was like a 3-mana 4/2, that'd be a little bit better, I think. I mean, we can take a Pyro Spawn for the top of the curve, I guess. Otherwise, we take an Evolving Wild. We're not gonna, I don't think we're gonna run a second Massive Might. I don't think I'm gonna run a Lightning Wolf, though. I'll take it. Maybe we end up with some stuff that cares about other wolves. We got a Daybreak Combatants. It's late for a Griffling Cavalry. Yeah, nothing for us. For us. I'm just gonna take an uncommon. Okay, so I'm gonna take this Reckless Impulse. I don't know if it'll make the deck, but we'll see. Probably one of the best ways for this color combo to, you know, get card advantage. I'll take a second Massive Might, but I don't think we're gonna run that. All duds. Whatever. Black has seemed pretty open. Though I haven't seen a Bleed Dry or anything like that. Alright, we'll take this Rural Fruit. I don't think it's going anywhere. Path of Peril. Beautiful! Love to see a child of the pack here. I think we just slam that. Not a lot to talk about there. take one rural recruit out. Alright, meh. Much less exciting. We can go with a spore crawler, or we can go with an apprentice sharpshooter. I think we are a little weak, to flyers right now, so I kind of want that sharpshooter. Just get a rock solid Hokan Mariner here. Yeah. I like the idea of picking up another 2-drop here, and it's got some synergy, so I'll take a 100 ritual. Another 2-drop is goodbye now. Alright, go ahead and cut that weary prisoner. I don't think we need a pyre spawn. Might cut this rural recruit. Might cut this lightning wolf. Probably more the lightning wolf, huh? I'll take a second sharpshooter, but I don't know that we're gonna run that. We don't want any of this. I'm gonna take an uncommon. Cut one of these sharpshooters. See how many wolves we have? Not that many. Put the state break combatants in the sideboard. I don't think we're gonna run two. Yeah, we don't want any of this. Stop giving me your groom's fineries. We don't want them. Yeah. Nooting. This last pack has been, outside of that child of the pack, this last pack has just been bunk. Bunk. Okay, so the one thing, jeez Louise, how many rural recruits? No, I want a stitched assistant. So yeah, what I was gonna say was the, jeez, alright, green. The Wolfkin Outcast also looks at werewolves, so what do we have werewolf-wise? 4. Okay. So, yeah. Seems like blue. Pretty open this pack. I wonder if there were any. Plenty of crushing canopies to go around. I'll say that much. Are we at 23? I think we were already at 23, so we may not need to make another cut. Yeah. So, it's just a matter of, like, whether, you know, maybe, like, an apprentice sharpshooter, or, you know, even the massive might, or daybreak combatants might be better than, the lightning wolf, or the rural recruit, I think. We're a little heavy on 4-drops. 5 is kinda up there. I think that this deck is gonna run more aggressively. So that makes me wonder if, you know, you junk one of those 4-drops, probably the rural recruit for, like, the second massive might or the second daybreak combatants. down, like... Okay, a little heavier red. Huh. Alright. I'm gonna see if, we'll see if this ends up being a good call. We're not gonna have a lot of comparison points for it. Let's just get to the digital deck box art here. And I think what, really marries the themes here would be this child in the pack. So let's go with that. Alright, let's give it a try. So no bombs, but, I think the deck looks okay. Got an okay curve. Nice, aggressive, creature-based, sort of some werewolf stuff going on. Pseudo-werewolves, quasi-werewolves. This is not great, but I guess I'll keep it. Someone pondering hard over that first land drop. You gotta play the right one. Somebody gotta back it. Yeah, I'll go ahead and trade. Got a shark shooter. Vampire's Kiss. Yeah, let's check the forest. Hmm. I'll give him the zombie, but we gotta get through it at some point anyway. The outcast, the sharpshooter, and the ridge wolf. What do they want to do about that? Take down two of their blockers, just leave them with the snarling wolf. Just make this incapable of blocking. Oh, that doesn't work until it's flipped. Whoops. interesting move. Think we got. Well, they've got two blockers, yeah, they're still dead. Quite dead. Very good. Good deal. And to wait a few turns until we had a critical mass of creatures on the board to attack with, but we're in a pretty commanding position. Alright. This is another one that's just like, can we live until, gosh. I don't think that that's really the right call to keep this hand. I just have too much trepidation over, we got a three drop. Trepidation over tossing a, you know, what is ostensibly a play. Okay, we're just bailed out straight up. And could have an abrade here. Yeah. Rather you hit my belligerent guest with that than a... this. Massive might here or something. No. Straight up trade. Okay. Alright, let's see if we can hit big. Not really. Yeah, that's a problem. Alright, let's Massive Might here, and we'll strike. Shaky footin'. Big pummeler. Taxidermist. Alright. So we are essentially priced into trading reclusive taxidermists. Yep. Yeah, now we're dead. Yep. Magma Pummel, we just had let ourselves get low enough at that point that there was not going to be any good way to block that, because it was just going to punch us in the face when we did so, as soon as any of our creatures dealt damage to it. So, all right, we were in that one for a little while, but yeah, I think the Pummeler was kind of the turning point. Also just kind of stunk to hit no lands with that Reckless Impulse. But, I mean, that's just odds. That's not... it's not really saying anything about the cards in the deck or the play choices. I think I would stand by playing that Reckless Impulse there. Yeah, this hand is okay. We're gonna need some lands. Okay. Yeah, let's get on board.
going to be impossible to attack through. I don't know what to do about that weary prisoner. Yeah, it's just like... yeah, this is not looking great. I really don't know what's best to play here. I mean, we're just gonna get a 3-2 or a 2-2. We don't have good attacks. I mean, this is like, I can stare at it as long as I want, but... We're just choked on red mana now. They're almost in the position here where just taking the turn off to flip stuff is probably a pretty good call. And we just don't have a way to punish them for doing so. I mean, we'll end up with a 6-4, but... want to discard anything? Probably not. Alright, I think we should just play the Watcher. Alright. That was the turn. We can play this Combatants and hold up the Abrade. Yeah, we don't really want to do anything with that. Ooh, wow, yeah, that's not gonna be great. Alright, that's not awful. Down magma pummel or X4. Let's hold one of these Daybreak combatants back. Had to wait for it, but that Ballista Watcher came through in the end. Alright. Cool. Alright, yeah, gotta get that third win for the big bump. Gosh, if only one of these was a forest. Shoot. Gosh. I guess we'll keep this, but, I mean... We're a long way away from winning anything with this one. Thank you. we don't get that forest in our hurry, we're in a lot. Oh. Well, we gotta kill that. Alright, good deal. Let's go red, green. All right. On a mission to kill all of our stuff. Got a lot of removal. Acceptable. Yeah. good. To draw something extremely powerful there. We were priced out of this one. Yeah. Oh, we finally ran him out of throngs. Is this a victory? Oh no. Oh, tricky. Alright. Well, that was touch and go. Start with kind of a rough opener, and they got a lot of work out of both the Wretched Throngs and the Kessig Flame Breathers. All right, we got one more try here. These are just some rough hands. We gotta get a forest in here somewhere. You can't see the forest for the mountains. Beautiful. We got him. Whew. Ducked in. Wow. We got lucky getting that forest. And I think they missed a land drop. But, hey, we got there. Alright. Yeah, the promised land.
Not a particularly spicy little number, but it's getting there. It's getting there.
Does no one want a taste? Does no one want to live deliciously?
There we go.
Yeah, we'll keep that with the taxidermist in there.
Come on, server. Where are you at? Oh no, my internet has done a thing.
Well, it claims it's still online, but now, yeah. Marina has decided to shut down on us. Womp womp. Alright, well, should probably close it. We don't need Windows to report the problem. Thank you, though. All right, hopefully we didn't lose too much time there. That is not my avatar. Oh good, skipped us through a whole turn, great. Try to come back from that, but it's not looking great. Thanks a bunch, Arena. Oh wow. Yeah, we weren't meant to win this one. We were not. We're getting what we deserve. Jeez Louise. It's a good looking deck.
pack it in. That was disappointing. The disconnect in the middle is always... I don't know. I hate that stuff. Plus, it skipped us through a whole turn. Like, that's just lame. Oh, well. We got 3 wins, so... We will, we'll be as satisfied with that as we can. Cool. Crack a couple of packs for you guys. At least the packs are always there for me. Even if Comcast isn't. Shattered Sanctum. And a Hallowed Haunting. Okay, alright. I know I've heard about that one several times now. Failed to grok exactly what it does. Anyway, thank you guys so much for joining me. Again, it's John with People's Republic. Check out peoplesrepublicmtg.com as well as our Facebook page for more info. But we are the best play group in the Atlanta area. Prior to the pandemic, we draft together in paper once a week. We are having periodic events amongst our fully vaccinated members. So if you're local, please do find me on Twitter. That's DirtyCurdy27, DirtyCurdy27. I can help you play with the group. You are also watching this on the YouTube channel where the handle is the same, DirtyCurdy27. Anyway, the last message for you is that this channel does stand with the Black Lives Matter movement. So check out the links to funds and charities in the YouTube video description below. Consider giving part of your monthly magic budget or anything that you would donate to my channel to one of those worthwhile causes. Anyway, I will see you guys next time.